A non-profit aviation safety group in the US has been warning about this risk for some time, more than a year. In October 2020, the Radio Technical Committee for Aeronautics, RTCA, put out a 200-page report that said in part, studies of the issue, quote, reveal a major risk that 5G telecommunications in the 3.7 to 3.98 gigahertz band will cause harmful interference to radar altimeters on all types of civil aircraft and has the potential for broad impacts to aviation operations in the United States, including the possibility of catastrophic failures leading to multiple fatalities in the absence of appropriate mitigations. Terry McVenes is the president and CEO of RTCA. I looked at the study. I didn't understand it. It's far too complicated for me. But I did read the executive summary, and I got the gist of that. If you were saying back then that it could be fatal and it could be catastrophic, why did nobody listen?
Well, I think a lot of people did listen. We've actually been working with some of our industry partners, along with the regulators, especially the FAA, in some cases trying to work a little bit with the Federal Communications Commission here in the U.S. and others, really for over a year now, to try to work out some form of mitigations. Mm-hmm.
If we look at what's happened elsewhere in the world, we were talking about, say, the UK or Australia. Now, France has come up with this halfway house of limiting or mitigating through the position. But the other countries don't seem to be as concerned as the US aviation industry. Is that because the bandwidths are slightly further apart?
Yeah, that's true. They've used some of the lower or further away parts of the spectrum band that they're planning to use here in this country. But also there's some other issues regarding the power levels that are being utilized in some of the other countries, the antenna tilt angles, and then, as you've already mentioned, some of the buffer zones around airports. So all of these things are have been used as some mitigations in the other countries, which they haven't done here or weren't planning to do here as yet. So it's really an apples to oranges comparison.
Right, and when we look tonight, JAL, Air India, Emirates. Now, we don't know whether they've cancelled their flights because they hadn't really factored in, or the flights had to leave here before they would have arrived over there because of the length of the flight. But do you think these airlines are being alarmist in cancelling their services?
No, I don't really think so. You know, we identified this safety issue, as you mentioned, back almost a year and a half ago now. And while there's still a lot of work to be done in terms of looking towards solutions, doing a good exchange of data between the aviation industry and the telecommunications industry, there's still a lot of unknowns out there. And it's those unknowns that are creating the safety risk.
Terry, how do we get out of this mess in the US now? You've got AT&T and Verizon both saying they will delay, but they delayed 2 weeks. My guess is they're not going to delay much more. You've got the sort of apocalyptic letters coming from the airline industry, and you've got no certainty that the traveling public can rely upon.
Yeah, that's correct. I think, you know, we've had a lot of time to kind of work through this, and we weren't real successful in getting that good collaborative exchange of information between the two industries. And as been pointed out, you know, putting new radar altimeters on airplanes is not a short-term proposition. We, as part of the work we do at RTCA, we've actually have a committee that's working on developing new standards for radar altimeters going forward. But this is a 2 to 3 year, 4 year process. And our standards that we develop are really just used as a basis for certification. And so that has to then be taken to the regulators, who then have to develop a rule in terms of how the altimeters are built. Mm-hmm. And then they have to be built by the manufacturer. So it takes a while.
It's going to take longer than a couple of weeks. That's for certain. Terry, good to see you, sir. I'll have another go at reading that report with a technical book next to me to understand it. Thank you, sir. I'm grateful.